So that's basically how we set up our new Anki deck, and I can add that one to it. Welcome back, everyone, to actually day 8 and 9 combined. I did do some studying yesterday and I did quite well, but I want to show you something today that's really important, that is really overlooked or underappreciated, should I say, by the language community, and it helped me a lot during my studying of French, and that is the use of Anki. So most of you that are familiar with language learning understand Anki, and it's not just an app for language learning, it's an app for learning anything, and it's flashcards basically. And I know people say, oh, when it comes to flashcards, but we really need to understand the value of these better, because it's space repetition. It's called an SRS system, space repetition system, SRS for short, and it's used in studying of anything. People, doctors use it to study. My son is going into the military soon and he's got his ASVAB test coming up, and so he's using Anki for studying his ASVAB test coming up. So let me just close this out again and see if we can find the app here for a second and show you exactly what I'm talking about. 1 second. So if you don't already have Anki installed, then I'm going to leave the link below so you can install it. But it looks just like this application right here. Once you've downloaded it, there's an actual website. I'll show you the website that we go to. Here is the Anki website. It's apps.ankiweb.net, and I'll put that in the description below here so you can find it. And in the meantime, we are going to open up Anki by going through my search, because I don't have it actually on my bar down the bottom. So there it is, because I looked at it earlier. Open up Anki. And once I've opened it up, I will show you some things that we can do with the Anki deck. And 100 most common spoken Spanish phrases. As you can see, it doesn't look like I've done any yet, and nothing's due, so I'll come to Spanish first. There we go. I'm doing too much studying. So my new cards are 20, and I'm going to hit study 100 most common spoken Spanish phrases, and I probably don't know any of them, but this is how this system works. So I hit study now. Por favor, I do know that one. That means please, or if you please, so that we know that one. So I know that's easy, so I can click down the bottom here. If you look where my arrow is pointing, it will give me that again in 4 days. So I'm gonna say that was easy, so I know it, like most people that you just had a rudimentary grasp on Spanish know that word, so I'm gonna say easy. It's not important. Importante is the French word. No importa. So I have a grasp of that. I had a good grasp of it, but I'm just going to put good so it'll come up again in 10 minutes. I'm exhausted. Is cansado? Is that hungry? Or is that tired? I'm not quite sure of that word. Cansado. I'm just going to have a guess. Estoy cansado. So I'm going to give myself that one. So I'm going to say good, show that in 10 minutes. ¿Hablas español? Do you speak Spanish? So that was an easy one, so I'm going to click on easy. ¿Dónde está el baño? Where's the toilet or the bathroom? So that one's easy too. What a shame. I know what it is in French, but I don't know what it is in Spanish. I'm going to have a guess. I'm going to have a guess. So I'm going to hit show the answer. Qué lastima. I don't know that, so I'm going to hit that one again. Come back to it. ¿Puedo usar el baño? Can I use the bathroom? Puedo is can, I believe. Usar el baño. Can I use the bathroom? May I use the bathroom? Okay, that was an easy one. When viaje. Is that good voyage? Good travels? Travel well. Okay, so that one. Socorro, socorro, socorro. Roll my R's. Socorro. I don't know that one. Help. Socorro. Don't know it. So I'm going to come back again. Hopefully it's going to stick in my brain. Hola. That one was the easy one. And you can see down the bottom here, I've got 10 more cards to go and then 4 more to study that's going to repeat later on. Show next one. So that's Buenos noches. Sorry, I hit that too soon. That's an easy one. I would have known that. What a shame. Here we go again. I don't remember what they said. Again, this is what spaced repetition is, to repeat, repeat, repeat. So show the answer. Que lastima. Que lastima. Nope, still gonna look for it in a minute. I don't want it. Yo no le puedo? I have no idea. Let's have a look. No lo quiero. Quiero is want. Yo quiero Taco Bell. Yo no quiero. Okay, so I do remember that one. But anyway, so I'm still going to put it on again so if I'm getting this. Socorro. That means help. Socorro. But even though I got it right this time because I just had it recently, I'm still not fully aware of it. So I'm going to put good again for that one. ¿Qué es esto? What is this? Or what is that? What's this? Okay, so that was an easy one. ¿Qué es esto? Yo comprender, comprende, ya entiendo. I think that's supposed to say bless you. There's a bit of a typo right here. To good health. Salud. Felicit. I don't know what that one is. So let's have a look. Salud. Duh. And then I do know what that one is. So I'll remember it next time. What a shame. Que latimo? Latimo? Lastimo. Que lastimo? Still don't know it. Let's come back to that again. I don't want to. Yo no. I don't want it. Yo no lo. To want. Yo no quiero. Yo no lo quiero. No lo quiero. Quiero. No lo quiero. Okay, I'm gonna put that as hard, but I still got it. Verdad. Verdad? We're going? Really? Oh, vraiment, in French. Verdad. I'll put that again. So, sorry if this is kind of off the charts here because I don't understand it all, but we'll keep going. I understand. Yo entiendo. Entiendo. Ya entiendo. Okay, so I'm going to put that one as easy. To good health, bless you. So, salud. Salud. Okay, got that one. I knew that one anyway. What a shame. Que lastimo. Que lastimo. Que lastimo. Okay, that one I'm going to put. Good, 10 minutes. ¿Cómo se va? How's it going? ¿Cómo se va? How's it going? Felicitaciones. What's that? Nope, I don't remember. I need to think about that. Cumplías. Cumpliaso. Okay, I think I was talking forever there and I'd had it on pause. So what I'm going to do now is take a break. Not take a break, I'm going to pause this for a second, finish up these cards. But you see, what's going to happen is they will re-show you everything you need to know, everything you've learned again in a few more days. For instance, if this one, how do you say? Como se dice? I had it very close, but I still don't quite know it, so I can actually put show me again in 10 minutes or in 4 days because it was easy. I was close, so I'm going to say 4 days for easy. Now what's going to happen in time is, in 4 more days, if I keep doing this every day for 10 minutes, 10, 15 minutes, which I only recommend 10 to 15 minutes, what's going to happen is it's going to repeat this again, and you're going to know whether you know it or not, and then you're going to put easy, and this easy now will change from 4 days to maybe 10 days, and then the next time it's going to change to 60 days, and so on and so forth. So this is going to change as far as duration before you see those words again. So I'm going to pause it for a second, and I will be right back when I have finished. Here's one pointer I wanted to make here. One pointer I wanted to make is when you do these flashcards and read them out loud, you're actually getting time to read. You're getting to actually speak rather than just listening, which is very, very important. It's probably the most important thing is to listen, but at least now you're saying the words. Even if you don't get them dead right, as long as they hear you and you're understood, that's the main thing. So I'll get back to you. And there we are. Congratulations, you have finished this deck for now. Now I'm going to show you how to use Babbel or Link and use phrases from there to make your own cards. Okay, so this is the best way to do it. You click on decks and it's going to come to this page. And if you look down the bottom here, create a deck. So now you're going to name it something. I'm going to name it, there's already one there. So here it is right here, Link Spanish right here. And I think I have Babbel Spanish also, so let's close that out for a second. And I have Babbel Spanish. Spanish Babbel Review, and then Link Spanish also. So I've already made some decks, but anyway, so what you'll do is hit decks, create new deck, and then type in the name of the deck you want to call it, and then add that to this list here. So I'm going to cancel that because I already have one. Okay, so now I'm going to open up the Babbel review section right here. So let's click on that one, and I'm going to, for options, I'm going to, no, those are daily limits, add. Click up the add at the very top here, so it's going to add to that deck. And the reason you know it's that deck is because at the top here where it says deck, it says Spanish Babbel review, and the basic and reversed cards. So I'm just going to pause that for a second. Okay, so now I am on Babbel, and I'm going to click on the time to review. Let's close that out, sorry. So I click on time to review right here. So we review now. Now, here's where the sausage is made. I'm going to use flashcards. You can do listening or speaking too. I like the flashcards because, again, it's just similar to Anki, but these are flashcards that you can now move over to your Anki deck. So let's go with the first one right here. What do you do for a living? Anyway, so I'm going to, what I'm going to do is, I don't know, so I'm going to, ¿a qué te dedicas? So I can actually copy and paste this if I want, or I can actually just type it over this, because this doesn't seem to be copy and paste anymore like it used to. Okay, so there's no way to, that used to be able to highlight and paste it, but you can't do that anymore. So what you're going to have to do is manually type this in. So, okay, sorry, this is a bit all over the place. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to put the front. Now you decide whether you want the front one to be in English or in Spanish. It's entirely up to you, but remember that it will reverse the card as you progress anyway, so it doesn't really matter. And the only other thing is, when you're on a regular typewriter, I don't know where the upside down question mark is on the keyboard. I haven't figured that out yet, so I don't use that right now, but I do know that it's a reversed or an upside down and flipped question mark in Spanish. So I'm going to put aquí, and some of the time it's not the accent on there too. I can copy and paste that, which I may do later. Dedicas. Put my question mark, and the answer is, what do you do for living? Question mark there. What I can do is I can actually find something with an accent on it and just copy and paste that onto my E right here. I don't believe there's a keyboard on here anywhere. If anyone knows of an easy way to do that, let me know down in the comments, because I haven't quite figured that out yet. I know I can change the keyboard on here, but it's still a QWERTY keyboard, and therefore the keys are still the same to me, so it's hard for me to differentiate between one keyboard and another if it's only in QWERTY. So if anybody knows that answer, please let me know. So without further ado, so we've done that, and then what we do here down the bottom is add the card. Okay, that's it. So then I didn't know the answer to that. I do know the answer, but I got it wrong. So now I can click on no, and the next one is, we work as psychologists, we work at a clinic. Nosotros trabajamos esta psicolig. Just keep trying, speak, and oh. No, that's French. Nosotros trabajamos en clínica. So, before I go on with that, I'm going to type this in. Okay, so I've typed it in, and I'm going to click on the answer. I was really close. Nosotros trabajamos como psicólogas. Nosotros trabajamos en una clínica. So I'm going to type that in here now. Okay, so I've added that into the answers. Now, here's the great thing about that is, as people know, as you're making your own cards, and there's a psychology to this, I know there is, as you're typing the words into your new Anki deck, you're actually learning at the same time. So it's a double technique, basically, because number one, you're taking a guess and trying to find out what the word means or what the phrase is, and you're putting it into the Anki deck, and at the same time you're learning. So as I was typing that, I was actually saying it out loud, so that gives me that double, sometimes even a triple shot or bite at the same apple, which is fantastic. So that's basically how we set up our new Anki deck, and I can add that one to it. Let me just answer this first. I was close. Didn't quite know it, but I'm going to put yes anyway because I was really close. And I'm not going to do the next one. So I can carry on. What I normally do is go through this whole deck of learning and put it in there. Here's the key that Anki about Anki, though. If you put in the same one again, say, for instance, this comes up again, this particular deck of cards, this particular review session on Spanish in Spanish. If this one comes up again and you put it into your Anki deck under your Spanish Babbel review, if it's already in there, it will come up pink. This will highlight in pink, and it won't allow you to add it again because it's already been added. Let me see if I can show you what I'm talking about. Okay, for instance, if I put in this word, la parada, parada, it, see how it's already highlighted in pink around the circle? I mean, around the border? That tells me it's already in the deck, and that's duplicating it. So that will stop you from duplicating it. So it's already in there, so we'll take that out. So thank you for watching today, and I appreciate your time. I know it's been a long video today. Hopefully I'll do shorter ones in the future for you so you can get through them. Hopefully you learned some things about Anki also, things that I've learned over the years of learning French. This should help you along with your journey, and please don't underestimate the power of SRS, spaced repetition. It's very, very important to your Spanish or your language learning journey, should I say. So in the meantime, I'd like to click on the button here for another video, I think right about here somewhere, or maybe right about here somewhere. And don't forget to subscribe around here somewhere, I believe it is. Hopefully I'm pointing in the right direction. Anyway, like and subscribe, and please let your friends know about the video, and hopefully we can build up our following. And thank you very much, and I'll see you guys either tomorrow or the day after, and happy learning.